one thing about the meal time, because we'd have so many compassion kids around, and then our project was like near some like slums and all that, so we have all these street kids also hanging around the project because they know that on Saturdays there's food that they cook for the children, so they would also hang around. But the good thing is that they would make sure the compassion kids eat, and then after that they would give food even to these other children who are out there. And then they would also, if like the case where you're saying about having to bring your siblings, for us they would allow you to take some food, just you can carry some and go back home with it. So that was really good.
Wow. Actually, that reminds me of one of my heartbreaking moments when I worked in a compassion center. One of the kids came running up to me to report to me about a friend who was keeping food. And so this girl, I think it was a routine every time she came to the center, and just like, you know, in the same situation like you, she wanted to share the food with her siblings at home. So the other friend didn't know what this girl was doing. So she came to report her, thinking that I would discipline her because of what she was doing. So it just broke my heart, you know, when I talked to this girl, you know, one-to-one, and she was like, yeah, at home, you know, there is no food. So when I come to the center, you know, I just think about my family. And so she was keeping the food in a bottle, in a mineral water bottle. And it just broke my heart. I couldn't believe it. So.
Talking about food, is the time would come and, you know, share you know, our struggles with the project director and tell them, you know, we're struggling at home, there's no food. And, you know, they would share the food that they give the kids. You know, he would go to the store, you know, scope how many cups of rice, cups of beans, and give you to take home and share with the rest of the family. And I feel that was being part of the community and serving the larger community.
Yeah, I remember many instances like that, even for me. Because I used to volunteer the project sometimes, and then I would just talk to the social worker because I need food to take home, and they would just go with you to the store and they'll give you some food. Of course, they can't give you a lot of food because it has to be accounted for, and they have to provide for the other kids on Saturday, but they would make sure that you are not struggling so much to be there, you know. So that was really cool.
I have also memories when every month the cooks will make the schedule for the whole. So they will put in detail what they were gonna cook for, what drink you were gonna get, if it is like juice, and it's like what is the main dish, or is it gonna be salad, is there's gonna be a dessert, or there's gonna be like a fruit. It's like we were looking forward to that specific day that we liked. I was like, so yeah, it was so much fun because we already kind of knew what we were gonna be eating for the whole month, and it was something that we would really look forward to have.
One of those days, yeah, when I was always also looked forward to the center days. Because I knew that that was a time for me to drink some milk because I wouldn't get that at home and eat a boiled egg. And so I always looked forward to a Saturday. Whenever it was a Friday, I would, you know, I would just prepare my appetite.
Like when Moses was sharing that he loved porridge at his project, I was totally opposite. I hated porridge. For me, whenever the porridge was there, I had a fat friend who would always take my porridge, and I used to give it to him. Okay, here you go. Because it was compulsory that we ate what they gave us and not complaining, because that is healthy to your bodies. As a child, I didn't really bother about health. I told, you have it here, take it. And he shared my porridge whenever the day was. And when there is something that I liked, he gave it to me, and I told, I gave you the porridge, so you want to take this. And he gave it to me, and we shared.
Did your porridge have milk in it?
I did.
Yeah.
But I'm not such a good.
What flour were they using for the porridge? Is it millet or corn?
I don't really know how to say it in English.
Okay.
There was some kind of.
I'm a geek.
What would you say? What's the English word for it? Indian term?
There was milk. We call that rava.
Okay.
Or sometimes it's a kind of a flower, which I don't really know what we call that in English. So
what color
it's just porridge.
Wait,
Where my mother used to make cornbread for me to go out to the streets and sell, so we could, you know, get our rice and, you know, buy our stuff. And I remember she used to give me cornbread for breakfast. And then what she gave me for, you know what she gave me for lunch?
Cornbread.
You know what she gave me for dinner?
Cornbread.
Corn soup. And I say that and we laugh now about that, but back then we were mad. We were like, man, we're getting the same thing every single. Now we go to the Compassion Project and at least we get variety of stuff. And we are grateful for that, even if it's something that we don't really like as much. At least it wasn't cornbread, so I was really happy about it. And I really, you know, thank God for that, you know.
And we always have that friend that will help us like finish our portions. Because they would, in my class, they will not let you continue with the next thing until you finish your whole portion. Oh, wow, and I was always the kid struggling to finish. Yeah.
I was that kid always going for the second help. So I finished my first plate and I'll go and look at the lady with, you know, some eyes, you know.